Hello guys, in this video I am going to explain you what is container widget and what are the properties in it. When you need to style a widget like background color, shape, size, try wrapping it in container widget. Container widget helps you to compose, decorate and position child widgets. So click on this text and hit on Alt Enter. It will suggest you some widgets to wrap around text widget. For now, I am using this container widget to wrap around this text widget. So after this text, I am adding a comma and I am going to add color to this container widget. So I am using color property and colors widget. I am going to add a blue color to this container. So let me run and show you. So this is a widget. I have added color parameter in container widget. So the container widget itself sizes to its child widget. The next property I am going to show you is a padding property. The padding property is used to add an empty space between child widget and the boundary of container widget. Use a property called padding. Just type in edgeinserts.all. You can add in the space to any side of your child widget, but for now I'm adding to all sides. So I'm adding for 8 points. Let me run this and show you how this padding property works. So this is a space between child widget and the boundary of container widget. So you can add any amount of space or any other side of this widget. The next property which I am going to show you is an alignment property, which is used to position the container widget at anywhere you want, like top, bottom, left or right, or center left, center right. So use this property and alignment dot. I am going to use center left. Let me show you this. So in the screen the text have added at the center left, and by default alignment will expand to its parent's height and width. So you need to add width and height properties to your container widget. Add a comma and click here, hit on enter, then add width property. So here I am going to give width for 200 and height is 100. So run this. So next I am going to show you a property called decoration, which is an important property or common user property for any type of applications. So if you use decoration property, you should keep the color property inside this decoration property only. So let me cut this and paste it here. So for this container widget, I'm going to add a border. So add border property and border dot all. You can add any side you want the border. So and also I'm going to add color to this border. Here here is a border, but its width is very less. Just I am going to increase its width, add a comma and add a property called width, and I am adding 5.0. Let me run and show you. So you can see clearly the border have added at four sides. And the next property which I am going to show you is a gradient property. To add colors inside this container, let me type gradient. And make sure that you should add this gradient property inside box decoration only. So type gradient property, and you can add any gradient from this, but for now I am going to add linear gradient. And inside that I am going to use a colors property, and inside the square brackets you can add a list of colors. So I'm going to add first a blue color, add a comma and add one more color which is light blue, and at last I'm going to add one more color. So add a comma and colors dot white. So these are the three colors which I have added in this container widget. So you can add any number of colors to style your container. So this is a container with three different colors. You can do experiment on different properties of container widget. So thanks for watching. Please do subscribe and like.